very thankful to people of Umbi, say, and as well, I'm thankful to you. A lot of you said you've not seen me for a while. These are difficult times. These are trial times. Normally, I shouldn't be here for up to 1 month. Things are not normal, you know? I'm somebody who battle every day of my life. I don't know why that is the case, but as you know, so Chukwuma and Kekamand. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. I'm Okulo Oro. I'm going to be here for just 5 minutes. I'm going to be here probably for 5 minutes, and it's going to be to thank the people of Mbise, most especially our brother, our father, our uncle, a great man, Iroko. Agarabachiozo. Ogaranyan Ejeru Mobonyezi. Ogaranyan Garanga. Odoguna Mbise, Odoguna Anibu, Onyoman America. Abilene Shedrak Enogwe. He's a very good man. He's an incredible personality. And if you know me, I love to spend a lot of my time appreciating, encouraging, thanking, praising incredible people. And one of them is from Mbise. For those who feel, who thought, who believe, who's insinuating that there are no good people in Mbise, billionaire Shedrak Enogwe, he lives in the United States of America. He's a true son of the soil. He is from Mbise. He is from Imo State. Only our brother Victor more than 2 plots of land. And as I'm talking to you, fundraising is ongoing. Mbise Global. Forum Mbise Nine. WhatsApp group Nine Mbise Wenowa. Everybody. They are together. They are talking. They are liaising. They are conversing. They are having critical Hanojen conversation. Mbise home and diaspora. They're listening to the story of Victor, how the parents, their properties were demolished or rather destroyed in northern part of Nigeria. Ebegompa Victor Oko. And he is no longer healthy. The chance of survival is not much. And Victor, being a son of the soil, a true son, he wants to bring the parents back home in case. Victor, and all that. So, after going through that, people of Umbi say they were remorseful, you know. We can't throw ours away. We can't push ours away, no matter the circumstance. So, Enyego Victor now. And they are not far from Nkakwa to Akwatu, and they raise the hand. Mbise people are very wealthy. Mbise is very wealthy. I can assure you that. And what if I get me Victor, Kali and Kone, maybe before. I know they will do that. I want to thank them. I want to praise them. I want to applaud them. This is not time for condemnation. I'm not. A lot of people feel that I am better condemning. No. If you are a governor, you are doing fine. I can come and praise you. If you are a senator, you are doing the right thing. If you're an individual, you feel the pain of people. When people cry, it touches your soul, your heart, your spirit. I can talk for you. Billionaire Shedrak Enogwe, a very good man. The first time I spoke to him on the phone was when I was being taken to hospital. When I returned from Opanko, I was very weak. And I was dehydrated. I was going to hospital when he called me. I told him I'm on my way to hospital. He gave me 100,000 naira. I don't know who billionaire Shedrak Enogwe is. He doesn't know me. I have never seen his picture. I don't even know him. If you bring his picture, I don't even know. But Osimunna, hey, itakwa na afu ifi ma de kwa nizi. Kama ikakwa ni mi yona, me yona. Ne 100,000 naira we ju na ogu. If I may, after can see your bank obata. I return from our bank, I think on Saturday, or born on a Monday. He gave me 100,000 naira. Incredible man. So, any Mbise man or woman, wherever you are, you need to raise your head. You know, raise your shoulder. Be proud of yourself today. As you know, onu kurunjo ge kumma, ekugo munjo against you. And I've sent my apology, undiluted, unadulterated. And today, unu emegumma. Unu sinafikta bungu unu. Ekene de kwa Ikoro Media as well. I listened to Ikoro Media this morning and I become more proud being an Igbo man. You know, as you ozo ozo yabacha. You know, where you hurt, where it becomes dangerous and deadly is also cha milizo siya dolo naana. Ona adima milizo na obacha. That is why eja wagota and all that. Drainage system. Milizo siya obase obacha. So, mirini inezo na opanku village. Lezini hite. Mbise obacha go. We are dialoguing. Onye abuna na yezi bi yabiko. Mwa ambuzo yabiko. And also want to send my apology to Igwe Omara, the third of Amo Omara. Eze Amo Omara. Onye eze. Omu wabu ukulo randi. Wabu mwa ge. Mwiko abu na mbo wabu omu omu ge. ife ọbụla m kwu bụ ife adọrọ m onye eze gbaghalụ unu emego ife unu kwesịrị ime andị ọ bụrụ na m ayọkọta biko gbaa unu niile obi mana m abụrụ ezigbo nwa mana m abụrụ okwulu ọra ndị igbo ịma na m bụ destrọkshọn ti igbo land and not peace. If I don't beg you until you forgive me, you call me to say okay. And then I'm not a son of the soil. I am evil. I am devilish. I shouldn't be talking on behalf of Igbo people. In fact, Igbo should be removed from my name. I was listening this morning. I was happy. Ndị ọkpanku jubiri, all of them came together. Kpọrọ engineer Victor, jego Siana. Siana na bụ nke ya. Ihe ọbụla ga-eme ebe eme. We are going to fully support. Ndị ọkpanku, if I may yesterday and I got the video this morning. And I'm very, very happy. Very, very happy. Thanks to everybody who was part of this, should I say thuggery, this battle, or these verbal utterances and all that. What more words do I use? I'm very, very excited this morning. I've not been here because I'm having challenges here and there, here and there, here and there. But if you're a warrior, you might not even enjoy a day in your life. You fight every day and I'm enjoying all the challenges. I am Okulora. This is a memorable day for me. This is a big day, you know. Echena by now, I'm gonna have way way, but look at us today. We are happy. We are grinding. We are talking. We are moving from 1 to 2, 3 to 4. Nwada Chimereze, na Netherlands. Ezigbo Adam Bise, chief. And when you know, Echena also working as chief. When we feel one, you may cheer your chief. You become a chief. Nwada Chimereze, na Netherlands. A man na Amsterdam, kwa Eindhoven, kwa Hege, kwa Herven. Wa fair no the key no ebe obu na ino na na Netherlands ya ma alugi mma onye obu na broker peace. A lot of you, we are in between, you know. You talk to this party, you talk to the other party, trying to broker peace, trying to remind me that I stand for peace, that I should apologize. So if you're one of those who asked me to apologize, you did the right thing. If you're one of those who asked me not to apologize, you still did the right thing. You know, everything can go, but opinion wouldn't go. Opinion. You are opinionated. You are entitled to your opinion. If I feel or thought or believe that what you are saying is wrong, what I have to do is to defeat you with a superior argument. We've made argument. We've talked. We've called. We've fought. And all that. But look at where we are today. We are joyfully talking. We are rejoicing. We are once again saying thanks to people of Mbise, Abombise, Ezinihite, Ebobunisi, Ezinihite. Ebe ọbụla isi na Mbise echefugo m. Ama m na enwe abọ, enwe ahịa azụ Mbise. I am very, very proud of you. I love you. Don't ever listen to anybody who tell you that I don't love you. I have met a lot of Mbise people. None of them have done anything bad to me directly. I have not. All the Mbise people I've met in my life, men, women, ladies and gentlemen, boys, girls, kids, grandfathers, grandmothers and all. They are incredible people. Enwe ajọ mmadụ ebe niile, enwe ezigbo mmadụ ebe niile. I love you so much. Thank you for everything you've done. Thank you for your encouragement. Thank you for your love. Thank you, everybody. Mbise Global Forum. Mbise whatever group Mbise ino. I am happy with you and I pray you are happy with me as well. Thank you very much. Thank you. Ndị Mbise no Canada, ndị USA, ndị Germany, ndị Italy. Ndị nọ na South Africa, ndị Ghana, ndị Morocco, ndị nọ n'Imo State, ndị nọ na ebe ọbụla nọ Ecuador, ndị South America, ndị nọ Colombia, Uruguay, Paraguay, ndị Venezuela, Bolivia, ndị North America, ndị El Salvador, ndị Cuba, USA, Canada, ebe ọbụla nọ. I want to respect you this morning, you know, Bikon, gbaghalụ ụnụ m, ife ọbụla m kwuru adịrọ mma, I'm sure that I've said so many things out of anger and frustration. When I went to Victor's demolished house, you know, I was being a human, you know, in the property matter actually. I was being a human at that point, you know. I said, well, oh, fuck, I can't want to if I will call the boy, cheers. That is why you have two hands. So, because I'm alone, Beacon, Igbo land will not be complete without you. As no one catch and wear bishop in an Igbo, a man or bishop or priest, I don't know, but it's a fact. I went to Mbise, I was told something by my friends, and reaching Mbise, I was able to verify. Mbise kasi aga akwụkwọ na Igbo. Ndị Mbise kasi aga akwụkwọ na Igbo. So, enwe a lot of good things about you. Bikon, thank you very much. Bilonia Shedrake Nyogwe. I don't know if I'm pronouncing your name correct, sir. And I'm sure one day you are going to get this video. You don't need to be here for me to say good things about you. You are an incredible man. You are a good man. You are kind. You are the picture of our bank. You called me. You are a billionaire. You can easily tell the military at the 3rd Division or DSS to come and pick me up. Because you are a billionaire. I am son of nobody. I'm incapacitated. I don't have anything. A billionaire called me and was begging me to calm down. You can imagine. Billionaire Shedrake Ngogwe called me on phone after my visitation to a bank. He was begging me. A billionaire begging a nobody. This is the type of society we want. We want justice to prevail. We want equity. We want equality. We want integrity. We don't want a society where people bully people because they have money. We don't want a society where people can call IG and say, get this boy, put him in jail for talking. No. Billionaire Shedrack Enogwe might be richer than my generation, but he called me on phone. He was begging me. I should calm down. Can I malify game? How many billionaires are going to do that? I got so near the far. Who is this tout? Who is this idiot? Ego akariji. He might decide to lock me for 6 months. Because I have nobody. I have nowhere to go. My father is no more. He's not rich. My mother is not rich. We are not rich. I am not rich. But billionaire Shedrack Enogwe, a good man, an icon, a man I'm going to tell my future generation about. His mentality is awesome. He lives in the USA. Maybe that's why. He's a great man. Ebe billionaire bo nwanwe ogbenye na here because have you seen? You know, I'm biko. I don't matter when you're able now to man. See no Shedrack Enogwe now young biko. All the care about Tezen, Bobom, the phone now, young because him cool, low down. You know, he sends a different signal. And I hope a lot of us are going to, copy from the billionaire. Open on one more when you cook with Boria Bochie. I'm a con one yan, you cook with any bokita, so on your cobble. Who? Mwonya. Open them every young one, you man, and I got today. I don't have anybody. The only people I have are you. All of you here are the people I have. I don't have money. My family don't have a state anywhere. We don't have anything. We are typical people who are trying to survive, who don't want to do anything evil. We are waiting on God to come one day and make a way in the wilderness where there is no way. We are waiting for him one day to come and bless us. And we are grinding, but for a billionaire like Shedrack Enogwe to call me and beg me, na simona. Even gave me 100,000 to go to hospital because I was on my way to the hospital. Sim nega muju no that I should take care of myself. No, the madam can ni bocho. After kogwasi mi fo we do ba mo do okenye ga do nwa ife nna ga agwa nwe ya. That is the Igbo land I want. I want everybody to have opinion. Whether you are rich, you are e-money, you are ateze, you are Femi Otedola, I want you to allow people who don't even have food to eat to have opinion. Money doesn't give you the world. Money might give you a little bit of authority, influence and all that. But in the end, we are all the same. And Shedrack Enogwe from today is my role model. I love him. If you know him, I don't know him. Even if you put his picture, I don't know him from anywhere. I don't know him. But he's a great man. All of you are incredible. I love you. I'm signing out. I'm going to be away for more 2 weeks or so. I am not very strong at this point. I am struggling, but it's the life of a warrior. You are not a warrior for you to be partying every day. Warriors are meant to encounter difficulties and all that. And I'm taking my own share of the whole thing. I'm currently taking my own share. So that is why you've not seen me on air for some days. I'm in difficult battle, and some of us know. On Sitenike Chineke, I'm going to prefer. I'm going to conquer. I'm going to win, as always. I've been fighting. I've been winning. I've been fighting. I've been winning. And this one is one of my biggest wins. Because it was turning to a thuggery, a war. And some of you told me the right thing to do. Mbise people, my fe. Mbise people will call me from America. They tell me okulo alright. Mete kwa nifa. Eka kwa nimi ona. But you know, we love you. You came to our land. You didn't make consultations. You took a one-sided report and all that. After criticizing me and teaching me, they'll still tell me okulo alright. We love you. How many people are going to do that? ebe mmadụ bịa kụọ nne gị ife, ị bachala onye ahụ mba, sikwu ya na-efo ya n'anya, ma ebe mmadụ bịa kwatuo nna gị n'ana. You know, this is what Mbaise people represent. I'm giving you first-hand information. I spoke to a lot of them on phone. They are incredible. They are incredible. I shouldn't be talking. I shouldn't even be hearing this thing because I have a severe headache. But I have to. You know, they say difficult times require critical look, or critical attention, critical assessment and all that. So if these things are happening and I do not bring them to your notice, then I am evil. Billionaire Shedrack Enogwe. He might be one of the richest in Imo State. He might be one of the richest in Igbo land. Even if not, Ifo Omere Emeberia before. You know how billionaires behave. You know how they behave. They can give IG 20 million to put me in prison for 1 year and nothing is going to happen. But this man is different. God bless him. God bless you too, wherever you're watching from.